So good morning everyone, welcome back to the chapter. So yesterday we have finished half of the chapter, half of the story, in which we have seen that William Tell was living on a high among the steep mountain of Switzerland, and he was unknown about the Gessler new law, new rule, that to bow in front of his hat, and when he passed through it, the soldiers stopped him and told that you have to bow in front of that your ruler's hat. But William Tell denied this, and he refused to bow in front of that hat. After that, Gessler arrived there and reached there and told that I know about you, that you are the most you are the best man, the finest man who can shoot with the crossbow in the land. Means he is the finest man, and he told that I want to check your skill in crossbow. Okay, now after this, he told that you have to shoot and show me that you are capable or not. And Tell also agreed on this and asked, I shall be glad to shoot for you, and said Tell, and where is your mark? Now we'll continue the chapter. Is this your son? Asked Gessler. Now the Gessler asked that, is this your son? Pointing to the boy. Yes. Is he a brave lad? Is he a brave lad? I think he is. Then he can help you. Let the lad means boy, a young boy, stand in front of the great oak and place this apple on his head. Now Gessler told that, okay, if you have to show your skill, then you have to place this apple on your son's head, and now you have to shoot your you have to shoot and show me your skill. If with one arrow you can hit the apple, then you shall go free. If you will be able to hit the apple which is placed on your son's head, then you can go. Only in for the one, means with one arrow, in one time. The cruel man smiled as he spoke these words. When he told this, he was smiling. He was the cruel one. Even his own soldiers were filled with horror. Now, the soldiers, by listening this idea of Gessler, this made scared to their soldiers too. Would you ask me to shoot at my own boy? Cried Tell. I will not do it. Now Tell was quite scared too, that how can I shoot at my own boy if the arrow will miss, and if it will hurt, it will get means, it will by mistake, it will reach to, it will get into his boy. It will be a dangerous thing. Now he was also scared and asked that I will not do it. But the boy, not afraid and looking into his father's face, he said, Father, I will stand straight and still. You never miss your mark. I know you can hit the apple. But the little boy was not afraid. He was quite sure that my father will aim the mark. And he told his father that, Father, you don't worry. I know. I will stand still and straight. You just have to shoot that arrow. And I know you never miss your mark. And I know you can hit the apple. The brave lad reached up and took it from Gessler's hand. Means the brave lad reached and took that apple from Gessler's hand. Then walking to the tree, he placed the apple carefully on his head. Now, Father, he said, I am ready. Now I am ready. He stand in front of that oak tree and he placed the apple on his head carefully and told his father that now you can shoot the arrow. Now I am ready. Tell. Looking over his quiver, picked two long, straight arrows. One he placed in his belt, and the other he slowly fitted to his crossbow. Talking, taking careful aim, he loosed the string. Now he was ready to shoot the arrow. The arrow flew straight to the mark. The apple fell short through the center, and the boy ran to his father, who took him in his strong arms. Now he shot the arrow. He shot the arrow on the mark. What was the mark? The mark was the apple, which was placed on his son's head. Now he achieved that. Gessler turned to William Tell. "Why did you place the second arrow in your belt?" he asked. "Because while shooting that arrow to the mark, William Tell, one arrow he put in his waist, in his belt, and one arrow he fitted in his crossbow." Now Gessler asking why you have put the arrow in your belt. Tell looked into the eyes of Gessler and said, "The second arrow was for your hurt. Had the first one harmed even a hair of my boy's head, if my boy's head hair was also been even harmed, then I have shot this arrow what I have placed in my belt. I will have must this was arrow just for your hurt." Gessler shook with fear at this bold words. Now Gessler was quite scared with this statement of William Tell, that he is quite possessive for his son, that even the hair of my child will be harmed. I am not going to leave you. Turning to his shoulder, he said, "Seize this man and take him to the strongest cell in my castle across the lake." Now Gessler told that, "Okay, now take this man to the castle and put him into the strongest cell." But as per the promise of Gessler, that if William Tell will shot the mark, then he would be free. But now Gessler was not ready to leave him. In fact, he told that put him into the strongest cell in his castle. Before Tell could move, the soldier seized him and bore him to a boat on the shore of the lake. Now he was seized by the soldiers of Gessler, and he was taken to the boat and on the shore of the lake. As they were rowing across the water, a great storm arose. Now when they were leaving to the castle, a strong storm blow arose in the sea, in the lake. The waves dashed against the boat. To add to the danger, darkness fell upon the water, and the men could not tell which way to row. Now the soldiers of Gessler were unknown about the lake and the water. The men were not able to see which way they have to row. At length, the soldiers in command turned to William Tell and said, "You are a sailor and know this lake better than we do. If we untie your hands, will you help to save the boat?" Now again, they needed the help of William Tell, and he can't trust on him also, because Gessler and their soldiers cheated with the William Tell, because as they have told, if you will short on the mark, we will make you free to go. But they didn't, and now also what happened, his hand was bound, but the soldiers of Gessler told that if we will open your hands, will you help us to row the boat? "I will," said Tell. Now Tell told, "Okay, I will." Then they cut the ropes that bound him, and as soon as he was free, Tell took charge of the steering oar. Knowing the lake well, he soon brought the boat close to a little point of the land. Now, as he was, his hand was free from that rope, he rowed that boat and took that boat to a small piece of land. Before they could stop him, Tell seized his crossbow and he jumped to the shore. He gave the boat a great push out into the lake. While he took that boat to the lake, now he thought of running out from there because he kind of think that he could not trust him because they have cheated. Now his hand was free. He took that William Tell took that crossbow and he jumped into the shore. He gave the boat a great push out into the lake and he ran away. "Seize him! Kill him!" shouted the leader. But he was too late. Tell had already hidden himself in the bushes which fringed the shore. Now he hidden himself into the bushes which was fringed the shore. It did not take him long to climb to his mountain home, where he was free from the power of wicked Gessler. He quickly reached up the place where he was leaving his home and far away from the power of the wicked Gessler. Not long afterwards, the whole nation went to the war against their enemy. Gessler was killed, and in the end, the brave people led by William Tell became free. Now, the Gessler was killed after a few years afterwards, and their country was free from wicked Gessler, and afterwards, and the brave people led by the William Tell became free. Now their country got free from William Gessler, wicked Gessler ruler. Okay. So the moral of the story is that if you are keeping some promise, if you are telling a kind of promise, then keep it. If you are telling you are promising something, then you have to keep that promise. Otherwise, it won't be a good thing while breaking that promise and all, okay? So, keep your promise well because it means a lot to, it means a lot to someone, okay? So, keep your promise well and this is all about the chapter, okay? Go with the assignments and video properly, okay? And you have to read this chapter by your own. Okay.